Can you give me your cell phone?
Sure.
I will. Also, in the meantime.
And do you give me?
And
you know, try to concentrate on this stuff.
Okay.
Can you give me your cell phone? See this, that's the link.
Okay. Make sure that we see that they are coming. But,
I have no idea.
Okay. Oh, you could write down something like hello.
They can hear you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
So this is the log, or what's going on? Or you just recorded it?
No, I didn't. Like it's yeah, this is still like. So it's this much like.
It's a lot. It's like 1 minute.
Just wait.
Wait, this is how it looks.
Yeah, I'm just thinking if I. But I have low battery, so probably it's better to put. So you can say.
I think these two people are just us, you and me.
Okay. Maybe wait until. But wait a second, is it broadcasting?
Yes.
Wait, it's broadcasting.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, I see. Yeah, but we'll wait for some time. Probably somebody will show up. Probably there will be the third guy. But I couldn't see who is who is watching, right? Could I?
I don't know how it works.
And I will need be to move in this one. One, two, and one. Let's get it on. Hi.
Hi.
Are you for phone 102?
Yes.
Okay, good. One additional online.
Is Trina?
Yes.
Probably if you click here.
No, no, it's already full. Okay.
Will you say that appear here? I have no idea.
Probably there is also lock. Strange.
No, like this is the broadcast screen. Probably you will see what is going on here. See, if you're right here, you will see what's happening.
But what screen is that one?
Hmm?
Oh, this is what it's showing. So I should. What should I do? Which one is showing me?
The other one.
But why I cannot see what's going on here?
Apparently, they didn't connect that thing and the one in YouTube, which doesn't make much sense. But
you connected. Why I didn't see
yours? You can write from here.
Okay.
But
will they see?
Yes.
Okay.
You are able to see mine.
Okay. What is this if I put here? Will I hear some sound?
You can click it. I don't think it's gonna be.
Okay, so basically, where is my? This is my main screen, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Somebody just crossed it. What's your name?
Kobe.
Yeah. Oh, nice to meet you, Kobe.
Nice to meet you.
We just will wait probably for 10 another minutes just okay. To make sure that people connect and there are no many people, so we'll be okay. How could I exit full screen? Just you know what.
Okay, you need to go to the view.
Okay.
So here there should be a video.
Oh, okay. Okay. Open. Okay. Did you do it in? Where is this? Another one that you are showing. Okay, let's see what's it. What's it written?
You need to go to YouTube.
Oh,
probably like one of those videos. See.
Okay, I'm just don't understand why here. But what will happen if I put here?
Nothing is going to happen. You will follow us from.
Could I do that?
Yeah.
Okay, so could I just. Oh, so right now I am. Is this me?
And these two in sync? Yes.
I'll just ask over here. Hi. So okay, it says, do you hear me properly? Could you please write down? I'm just asking the person who is online right now.
You are going to hear this like in around 1 minute. There is a little bit of a lag.
Okay, that's good. Okay, good guys. So we have at least 3 people online. So we will be waiting for another 5-8 minutes and we will start, just to make sure that people don't have any connections problem, okay?
That's fine.
Here. This is mine. No, because I will be
more. It works,
but I don't need to do this this way.
I think there is sufficient room to.
Oh, but I want navigate. To direct it to the first one. Oh, because this goes with the lock, right?
Go to the other one.
Okay, but but otherwise. Oh, but could you monitor this from your computer? Okay, so just monitor from that computer and see if you don't see something properly.
My water bottle.
Excuse me?
My water bottle. Nice.
see proper here.
Just a second. They're going to be seeing me. But like that part, it seems fine.
But I want to come to this one. So probably I will write this one after. Here, I will erase my this one. So it's fine.
What's going on? Oh, no audio? For what reason?
I didn't say no audio. I have my...
Oh, okay. Ah, yeah. I'm we just didn't talk, probably that's why you didn't hear anything, but we are still here. So if you still don't hear anything, don't hear any voice, so then write down again. But I think you everything should be properly set up.
It's better for you to monitor instead of doing this.
I can mount it.
Okay. Yeah, just 3 more minutes and it will start. So once again, do you hear me, Sas? Do you hear me?
I hear you.
Okay.
I was hearing you.
Okay, cool. See, six, a lot of people. Yeah, okay. Yeah, we are almost up to start. Just one more minute and we are starting with 10 minutes delay, but it's okay. What's your name again?
Sorry. Kobe.
Kobe. Okay, I will try to remember. I'm very bad with names, so I'm sorry. Yeah. I'm apologize for this. Even one person. It's good that only you came. Otherwise, we'd be in trouble. Okay, it's 1:40, so we are starting with 10 minutes delay. As for now, we have 6 viewers online, and we have one student present here. His name is Kobe, and we, according to plan. What we will do today, we will discuss problem number 1 and problem number 3. So you are more than welcome to ask follow-up questions. And these people who are watching us online, right, they will see everything that we are broadcasting with some delay. So after each problem that we discuss, we will make a small delay, small pause in 1 minute.
Okay.
And then we will allow these people to ask questions, okay? And there is my buddy Ramazan, who will be watching people. This is his hand. He will be watching people who are asking questions online, because we mainly have people online, so we need to respect them, right? Mm-hmm. We need to respect you guys from the other side of the screen. And right, that's it. And hope we with Ramazan not mess up, and this video will be later on posted for you on YouTube, and this way you could review everything, and this will allow also people who are not watching us, right, to make sure to review everything. Okay, cool, right? And let me say the last word before I start. So behind this 2 problem that you also have solution to, I will also discuss 2 questions from the quizzes if time allows that most of students have problem with.
And I will discuss these two particular problems, but this is only if we have enough time, okay? Okay, so let's start. So problem number 1A. So let me remind you what was asked in this problem. So there was Joe who runs a farm, and he rents a land for $100 per day, okay? And he can hire workers for $20 per day. And this means that $20 per day he pays for each worker that he hires.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't necessarily hire at least one, but if he hires, he needs to pay $20 per box, per worker. Sorry. His short-run production function is given in the following table. So here I'm not going to explain all the solution. So I will concentrate just on the first three rows. Okay. But I will explain them as detailed as possible. That's if you could do it yourself. And of course, if you have questions, just post them on Piazza tomorrow and I will answer them. Okay? Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So what is given in this table for you? So given number of workers, as I said, you could hire 0, 1, or 2, probably more, but we'll mm-hmm. concentrate just on this one. And output, so if you have 0 workers,
yes,
it's bad. You couldn't produce anything. So if you have 1 worker, you could produce already 10, right? But if you have 2 workers there together, so you could produce 25, even more.
Uh-huh.
The more workers you have, the more you could produce. So this information, if you have similar problem on exam, this information will be given for you, okay? Okay, very good. So right now, we need to find out marginal product, okay? Okay, do you remember what marginal product is, Corbin?
Is it marginal product, is that equal to, no, that's not equal to, is that equal to price? No.
No. So marginal product is basically how much each additional worker adds to the production, okay? So say we have here 1 worker. Before we had 0,
mm-hmm.
right now we have 1. How much this additional worker adds to the production?
Oh, 10.
10, correct. How do we know this? We just subtract 0 from 10, right? So we will have 10 here. Yeah, and we are filling in this matrix column by column. There are
okay.
different ways, there is no, you don't need to follow specific procedure, it doesn't matter. As long as you got all numbers correct, it's fine. Right, you got full credit on exam. Nobody could even verify how you filled in this matrix,
uh-huh.
right? But for me, it's just easier to do it because I'm broadcasting it online. So for me, it will be much easier than messing up you guys and moving back and forward, okay? So we have 10 here. Let's do the same. So we added 1 more worker here. Right now we have 2 workers.
50.
So how much this worker adds up?
15.
So Kobe is saying that it will be 15. So how do you know, Kobe, that it's true?
Because you just subtract the 25.
Yes, so you're subtracting 10 from 25 and you get in 15. Okay, so we have 15 here. Okay, cool. So once we're done with this, we're going to TVC. And TVC means that total variable cost. Okay, so variable cost is the cost that varies with production. The more work, if we change the workers, this cost will be varying. Okay, so what is varying cost in this problem? So we have 2 types of costs, right? One is for land, and one is for workers.
Mm-hmm.
So which type is varying?
Cost per workers.
The cost per workers, right. Because if we produce the same, if we produce different amount of output, we need different amount of workers.
Mm-hmm.
And as a result, the cost varies. Because for each worker, you need to pay additional money. Okay, so total variable cost, if you want to hire 1 worker, it will be
$20.
$20, right. Because we are paying, for each worker, we are paying 20. So if we hire 2 workers, 1 more,
$40.
It will be already 40. So this is basically just accounting, nothing more.
Mm-hmm.
So let's go forward. Let's think about total fixed cost.
Okay.
So already?
Well, how much was the rent is the fixed cost? And the rent was?
$100.
$100 is the fixed cost the same? $100.
Yes. So this is the easiest one. So this always you need to remember. So if you have
mm-hmm.
total fixed cost, it doesn't depend on the number of output you are producing. So it's always the same.
It's always the same.
So it's somehow you're filling in a lot of cells, but in fact, it's just a lot of extra credit. You need just fill in exactly 1 cell. All others you're getting for free.
Okay.
Okay. So we are just filling in 100. For whole column, and actually, see, here we have 0 workers.
Even if you not employ anybody, you still need to pay this.
Yeah.
You rent the land, it's your problem that you calculated something wrong. Okay? So it happens in real life. So we're studying real life example. Okay? Good. Let's go to total cost. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
So how do we calculate total cost?
Is that the price or no?
No, no. It's price. So guys, I know that this question, since I know that Kobe is the only one, so we are who is live here. So we are fighting with Kobe, he's answering my questions. There are one more question, but just second Ramazan. Let me answer this. But I saw also on Piazza somebody posted this kind of question that's asking, oh, cost is related to price. So there are two sides of the problem. So one is cost analysis, and here we calculating all this cost, different costs, variable cost, fixed cost, and there is other side when we want already to price our product, to sell it in the market. Okay? So this is already selling and producing. So this is different size. So not mess up like price in the cost analysis. Okay?
Okay.
So total cost will be, just let me finish and I will return to the question from the person who is asking online. Okay? So total cost is basically, it's named total because it's total. It's sum of all costs. Okay?
Okay.
And we have just two costs. We have variable cost and fixed cost. So let's sum them up. So what you're doing here, you're summing up two previous columns. Okay? So 0 plus 100 will be 100.
Mm-hmm.
20 plus 100 will be 120.
Mm-hmm.
And 40 plus 100 will be 140. And before I proceed further, let me answer the question from the people. Probably they already even got and they don't need the help, but we'll anyway be polite and answer the question, okay? So what was the question?
How did you come up with the total variable cost?
Total variable cost. So let me explain one more time how I came up with total variable cost. So here, variable cost is something that is dependent from the number of units you are producing, okay? So we are considering this situation, this line, say second line, and you want to produce 10 units of output. But in order to produce 10 units of output, you need to hire one worker. But how much you will pay for this worker?
$20,
right? So this is variable cost. Why it's variable? Because if we hire zero workers, it will change. You will pay nothing, right? And if you hire one more, you will pay additional. Right? Moreover, we know that we couldn't mess up and put 100 here, because we know like this is fixed cost. Whatever number of units you are producing, you will pay the same 100. So this is how I explained before, this is free extra credit. You know one number, but you fill in the whole column. Sounds good? I hope the person that heard me will say, the person we responded to the answer, if it's clear what we just talked about, let this person just write down, yes, it's clear, and we will proceed. So,
what is the total variable cost when there are two workers?
Two workers. So the total variable cost for two workers will be 40. Because right now you have two workers, so 20 you paid for first one, 20 you paid for second one, so you sum up. 20 plus 20 gives you 40. Okay? Or you make multiplication, say 2 times 20 will be 40. Because it could be the situation that you have a problem and you have 200 workers. Of course, you will not be summing up 20 plus 20 plus 20 200 times. Okay? Is there any other questions?
No.
So far, no other questions. So we will proceed further. So one guy joined us. What's your name?
I'm Shay.
Shay. Okay. Did he pronounce it good? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Nice to meet you, Shay. So what we are doing right now, we filling on problem number one,
okay,
and we filled in half of the columns. We are only concentrated on 0, 1, and 2 workers.
Okay.
You could do the similar stuff, similar analysis at home. And since you missed part of it, we will not be answering your question about this part. But what could you do once you go home? You could watch it online and then clarify everything for yourself. Okay?
Thank you.
Good. So let us proceed further. So right now we are filling in this average fixed cost. Okay? So it's a little bit of calculus that we need to do right now. But word average means that we need to divide by something. Okay? But right now we just need, I know that some students mess up whether we need to divide by output or by workers. Okay?
And actually, we need to divide by output, okay? Because we are not interested so much in how many workers we have, but we're interested in how much per unit of output it costs to us to produce this good, right? Because then what we will do with this good, we will be selling this good. And then we will be comparing how much we paid to produce against the price that we are getting, right? It's clear. So for us, it's not interesting how much we paid for worker. Probably this worker will be so productive that he will be producing hundreds or thousands of these units of this product. So this will be, you know, like this will be not give us nothing if you will be comparing the price we are paying for worker and not the price but wage against price of the product, right? So it's better to say what is the cost of producing this particular product. Okay, so that's why we are dividing by number of output, right? And what we are dividing, it's here. So we have A in the front, but here it's fixed cost, okay? Where is our fixed cost? Fixed cost is over here, right? Mm. It's 100. So what we are doing, we are dividing by output, okay? So of course, here is missing because we couldn't divide by zero, it's illegal, okay? So we will be dividing second column. So it's 100 divided by 10. It will be 10, correct? Okay. 10. It's how we got this number. We divided 100 over 10. Once again. Total fixed cost over output. Okay. Let's do the same.
Where did you get the worksheet?
Oh, this is the homework.
She printed it out. Yeah, he printed it out himself. I didn't distribute anything. But this will be again. Everything will be online if you didn't mess up, you know. If you don't mess up, then everything will be online and you could review it after you go home. Right, so let's go here. So how we got this number, Shay?
100 divided by 25?
Yes, 100 divided by 25, and how much it would be?
4.
Okay, so you see, guys, sometimes we even don't need a calculator, okay? So let's do the same for these two columns. And Ramazan is still monitoring what's going on there. So this way, this is very similar to this one, but still we are... Since we are 1 minute delay for people behind others, behind the screen, so it will be good exercise for us to do this similar stuff, and then they could ask a question if something is unclear about these three columns. Okay, very good. So let's go be help me to calculate average variable cost.
Would that just be the variable cost divided by output?
Yes, so where is our variable cost? So here, 20 divided by 10. Be how much?
Two.
Two. Okay, good. And this one? So 40 divided by 25.
40, okay. I thought it was 10.
Oh, here, oh, sorry, it's 40.
Okay.
You know, like total variable cost, also be careful. It should, all these numbers, if you increase number of workers and output, it should increase.
Yeah.
Right? So it just couldn't be 10 here, even if I write something incorrect. So it will be 40 over 25. Here you will need the calculator. 1.6 probably. Okay. 1.6 something. So you need to be as precise as you can, but like 1 or 2 points, two numbers after a point, it will be more than enough. Okay. Okay, let's go with average total cost, right? So what will be average total cost here?
Average would you add 10 plus 2 as
well? Oh no, 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 guys. So here, okay. It's good that I have you, Shay, because probably the same mistake would do the guys. But let me see. No, it's probably will be right. Okay. Not me mess up. Yes, Shay is smart in math, not as smart as me. Yes, so there are two different ways of doing it. So Shay is proposing one of them. So you basically could just sum up these two numbers.
Yeah.
And this will be 12.
Which one?
Average total cost, we calculate in this column.
Oh, no.
So you could sum up these two previous numbers. So it will be 12. Okay. But there is other way to do it, just to double check that you did previous numbers also, correct? You're having total cost here, divide by number of output, it will be 12 also. So Shay is absolutely correct. Okay, so he slept much more than me. His brain is working good, so we have here correct, and we not only have here correct, but we also check this number somehow. At least part of it should be correct. Let's do this one. So that's to be 5.6, correct?
Yeah.
And this number, to double check, you could double check at home, you need to divide 140 over 25, and this should be 5.6. So Ramazan is monitoring whether anybody has any question regarding these three columns.
So someone is confused about the four.
About what?
The four. What is the four?
The four is already confusing.
No, oh, four.
Four probably here. Okay, so let me explain one more time this number four, where it comes from. Okay, so we have calculated average week scores, and we are calculating it that corresponds to two workers. Not only corresponds to two workers, it also corresponds to the number of output 25. And that's what we should be more careful about. So we need to divide over 25, just for the reason I explained a few minutes ago.
They are happy about the explanations. They don't like your force.
They think you can't read them?
You need to figure out a different four.
Okay. I thought it was a one.
Okay. I see, guys. So I will not be explaining it once again, so everybody is happy about the explanation. I will be writing four more carefully. So how do you write? Okay. Yeah, that's fine. Okay. You probably don't see the four that I just wrote.
2+2.
But but Shay just advised me how to fix this problem. Okay. So hopefully everything is clear up to this point. So I will proceed slowly to marginal cost, because I guess this is the most complicated part of it, honestly. Okay.
Yeah.
And we need to be more careful. So marginal cost is very important in the analysis, you know, because this is the cost of additional output produced. Okay? So this is very important, because when you think about, let me go a little bit to the theory. Okay? So when you think about whether to produce additional unit of output, you're comparing what could they get from it, right? So what profit could they get from it, right? What revenue, more precisely. So then you're going and see what's the price for this product, right? So if you could get $10, right? And then you think, okay, what's the cost? But you're not thinking what is the average cost of producing, but what is the marginal cost? What is the additional cost you need to pay in order to produce this unit of output, okay? And then you're comparing two numbers. If one is price is greater than marginal cost, you're saying, okay, I'm fine, I will be producing. If not, then you're saying, wave your hands and say, no, I will not be producing. Okay, this is simple how it is. So this is why this number is very important to us, okay? Let's come back to calculations. So right now, here we make simplification assumption that basically these 10 units, they were produced at the same marginal cost. We don't have any more information. So we need just to rely on this, okay? So here we have 120. This is 140, this is the total cost, okay? Let me just double check something very quick. Correct, this is 120. And we are comparing here the zero output, okay? In order to produce zero, the cost will be 100,
yeah.
Okay? So what will be the difference in the costs? 20, right? But I said that we assume that all these 10 outputs, 10 units of outputs, are produced the same cost. So right now you need to divide 20 over 10 to know how much each additional unit of output costs for you. Okay? So it will be, I will write down the formula, and I hope I will be very clear what I'm writing on. So it will be 120 minus 100, and this should be divided over 10. Okay? So I am subtracting 100 from 120 and dividing by additional number of outputs by 10. Okay? Oh, more precisely, I'm dividing by this.
So you could also do variable cost divided by the change in output.
Oh, you could do this as well.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Okay. So this was advice from Shay, was just to divide variable cost by not exactly by change of output, and this is the marginal product.
Okay.
I like his explanations better.
Yes, yes, yes. He should be the next instructor for this course. Very good. So let's do this simple calculation over here in marginal cost for here. So what we are doing, we're dividing total variable cost. It's 40. We're dividing 40 over increase in output, and increase in output is marginal product. Okay?
Okay.
And marginal product is here 15. Okay. So we are done with the table. We just wait for another minute that we have this 1 minute lag once again. We will wait to make sure that nobody has any question regarding this table. And if somebody has, we will go back and explain it one more time.
Do we have to complete this kind of table on the exam?
So guys, I am solving these problems not because they will appear on the exam, but just because these problems, with this problem, some students have had problems when had complications when solving their homeworks, and I decided to review this material. Probably it will appear on exam, probably not. But this I couldn't tell you during this session, so please not ask this question. Let's not waste our time, but be more productive and concentrate on what is important. Okay. Anyway, my recommendations for any kind of exams: review all the materials, especially all the assignments, includes homework and quizzes that were covered up to that point. So of course, for exam number two, it's not comprehensive. It just covers the material from starting from lesson three. From lesson five till lesson eight, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I will write down this information to you today. But I mean, it's limited material, but you need, for this material, you need to review all the quizzes and all the homeworks. And we are doing part of it here. So it will be easier for you to prepare for the exam. And you will see what will be on exam on Monday or Tuesday, or not on Tuesday or Wednesday, depending on when you will be taking this exam, okay?
Seth is asking a question that doesn't appear to be very correct. Total variable cost over MP, I get it as marginal product, being equal to marginal cost. Is that correct?
Total marginal cost over marginal product, because this seems what we just discussed.
So it's correct.
Yes, it's correct. What Seth is asking is basically correct, at least for this problem, okay? And I couldn't think about any exception.
Number two, should it be 40 or 20?
Number two. Oh, what do you mean? By
like instead of 40 over 15, and the marginal cost.
Here.
Mm-hmm. It should be 40 divided by 15.
Yes.
20 divided by 15. Do you understand what I'm asking? So is it the change in total variable cost divided by the change?
Okay.
This is
output. Yes. Okay.
Is
Shay,
what I'm trying to say?
Okay. Shay first is confused, and then we. Yes. So that was my mistake, Seth. It's wrong. Sorry. I did it very fast, and that's why I made mistake. So I apologize about that, and thank you for Shay to correcting me. So actually, the formula, there are two kind of formulas, and let me put it here. I think this will be. Ramadan, please check whether it's seen clearly. Where to put 4. Is it seen clearly?
I mean, I can see from here.
Okay, so there are two formulas that we are using that could be used and are both correct. So one is the change in total cost divided by delta Q. Okay. So what is delta total cost? Is the change in total cost. What is delta Q? Is the change in output.
Yeah.
And the change in output is marginal product. Okay. So what is other formula? The other formula is the total variable cost divided by total output. Change of total variable cost divided by change in output.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And this is again marginal product. Why these two formulas are equivalent? The reason is that here, what is total cost? It's total cost of producing, say here for this example, 25 units minus total cost of producing 10 units. Okay? Here, total variable cost is the same. Total variable cost of producing 25 units minus total variable cost of producing 10 units. But what is happening here, that you have here fixed cost, but fixed cost is in total cost here and a fixed cost in total cost here. So they basically subtract each other, and basically the result is a zero, and this will give us absolutely this formula. But I hope this is clear, but even if it's not, you just basically try to do math, try to calculate using this formula and that formula more precisely, and you will see, and you will get the intuition why these two formulas are equivalent. So I apologize for my mistake. The number that was written here is not correct, so I will correct it right now. I hope it still seems clearly, but I will correct it first and then move a little bit camera so that you could see it clearly. So I will use the other formula. So here, in this cell, I use the top formula, right? Let me here use the bottom formula. So here I need to subtract 40 minus 20. So I'm subtracting 40 minus 20 and dividing my marginal product by 15, okay? And it's a fact, like, coming back to my explanation, if you go back to total cost, right, what you need to put, one in here and one in here. So these two ones will subtract each other, okay? Cool. So Ramazan is asking one more question, so let me read it to you.
Seth is asking whether total variable costs over change in output is equal to marginal cost.
Yes.
And he is not correct in this, I suppose.
No, it's correct.
It is the change in total variable
cost. Oh, the change in total variable cost, yes. Yes, I am sure in change in total variable cost. Okay, so we are still waiting for Henry. She is asking when fixed cost is constant. But I think this is the definition of fixed cost. It's always constant, right? It doesn't depend on the number of outputs that we are producing, okay?
Nick is asking a question saying, which conditions do you use each formula in? Just the marginal cost? But the question doesn't seem to be very clear.
Do you use each formula in?
Yes, just Nick, if you can, please clarify what you mean. And Henri, if you just heard our explanation, say whether it's good enough. Because we're just waiting for another minute and we'll go further. And before the break, we will be able to finish this problem. We will have a small break just to refresh, and probably some other people will be connecting. I will be probably not like talking, but replying just to whatever their question
are. I think what he was trying to say is he thinks you use the formulas in different times. So maybe you should just tell him you can use either or both formulas.
Oh, yes.
And that's what he was trying to say.
Yeah, you need to use either one or another. You don't need to use different formulas in different cells. It's up to you, right? But the point of this exercise is to get the correct numbers. Which formula you're using doesn't matter, right? Even if, say, I don't know, somehow it came to your mind that numbers should be such as that, you will get a full credit on exam or in any of your work, you know. So any other questions?
Okay, now Seth and we are on the same page about marginal cost being equal to delta total variable cost over delta output.
Correct.
And Henry Chang is commenting, I would use the first formula since it's more secure if you're not sure whether or not the fixed cost is constant. I guess you're going to have a remark on this.
Fixed cost is constant. That's what I just told. I don't know what to repeat, but yeah, if you feel like first formula is more secure, use the first formula. If it's easier for you to remember or more clearly explain whatever.
And Nick is asking, what is the difference between total cost over quantity and total variable cost over quantity?
This we are not explaining total cost over quantity, but change of total cost over change of quantity. So this question is somehow not related exactly to this problem. So let us proceed. And if this Nick will be persistent in his question, then I will reply to him just in chat, and we'll try to figure out what confusion exactly is. Okay.
He's taking Q as quantity first.
Yeah.
So,
yes, it's not Q. Yeah. It's
label
delta
it,
Q. It's changed.
Label it output. Can you put an arrow on the one of the Qs and say output, not quantity change? See what I, you know? Do you understand what he's trying? He's making a mistake.
I think he's thinking it's quantity.
Yeah.
Like,
right.
Output.
It's out. I mean, like quantity of workers or quantity.
No,
of
he
work?
Like he's. You see DQ. You because we use a delta Q in other like previous questions last exam.
Uh-huh.
So he's taking Q as quantity, not output.
Oh, okay. So,
so
Q is
under
it. Yeah, under it. If you just put
like
output.
Q equals output.
Okay, let me
or maybe draw an arrow. And, yeah.
Isn't it the same?
No, you can do it's supply and demand, quantity
yeah.
curve, price curve. That's what he's.
Okay. Probably I'm confusing. Yes. So by Q I mean output. So I will check the notation. Probably I will write down something. But I believe this is correct notation in
yeah.
any case. But let me write down here output. Probably it will be much more clear. Okay. We have 5 minutes before break, so let me speed up just tiny bit. So what I'm going to do, I will just answer, it's fine.
You can answer this question, like what is the difference between total cost over quantity?
No, I already answered this. So let me proceed further. So let me do 1.C. And in 1.C, basically, in order to answer 1.C, you first need to fill in the marginal product for all different kind of for different number of workers and different outputs, okay? So I'm just summarizing, trust me, this is the correct answer. You could check it with answer keys, okay? But in order to answer 1C, what 1C is asking is basically, let me just check here. From which worker they have diminishing marginal return, okay? And basically how you figure out, you just say, how marginal product is changing. So once marginal product starts falling, this is where diminishing marginal return law stays in. Okay? So we have 10, then we have 15, it's small increase but still increase, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then we have 20, it's still increasing, right? So you're adding workers, but still each additional worker brings something even more. We become even more productive in some sense. So but here we have 15 already, right? So 15 already less than 20. Okay, that's why here this is the answer to this question will be starting from fourth worker. Okay, so if there are any questions regarding this, please write it down. So I will try either to say and answer it. But otherwise, we are making like small break, 15 minutes break. Oh yes, this is just a reminder that we need to take 15 minutes break. So, but try, the people online try to be back in 10 minutes, okay? And we also be trying to be here back in 10 minutes to make sure that this time we start in time, okay? Cool. And yes, good. Just keep it nice. You need to move here.
Good.
Because I need to show it here. And I will be need to check how it's seen clearly before the beginning.
Is there any time you will see marginal output also from 1 to 2 decrease?
Which column your
MP change in marginal product?
Yeah, but it's decreases here.
No, I mean, I don't know, from 1 to 2, is there any way to decrease?
Oh, you mean like from the beginning decrease?
Yeah.
Yeah, it could be that from the beginning you have decrease.
You could
have this. Probably like not in necessarily your homework or exams, but
yeah.
You could think that I'm trying to think about like production technology. But this basically what will happen in why we have marginal product decrease. So say we are producing something here in this room, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I don't want to speculate exactly what, but what is happening, we start to, you're basically staying on my way. So you're preventing me from doing something, right?
All right.
So it's not like we're gaining something from cooperation, but we're just hitting each other. In this way, marginal product immediately become drops. You add less than I added first. Because before I had all this classroom for my production, right? I was producing, I was independent, but suddenly Shay showed up and he started to hit me all the time when I move to the other window, right? Because I want to take some device on that window, but because Shay is there, Shay is moving in opposite direction, he's preventing me from going that way. So it could be that from the beginning you have decreasing marginal product. So yeah, so let me repeat the question because I did it properly. So like Shay asked whether we could have the law of diminishing marginal product to step in from the early beginning. And my answer was that yes, it could be. It all depends on the production technology. It all depends on the real life situation. So it could be analyzed in particular environment.
But you can't go like from 10 to 9. 10 to 20. That's what I'm trying to say. So like decrease then increase. Just because you added more people. Once it starts decreasing,
it's more decreasing. So you see, like I will not say that something like this is not possible, but in this class we are assuming some patterns, right? And these patterns are more observed in real life. That's why we see that it's first could slightly increase. Because when we are cooperating with somebody, when I'm cooperating with Ramazan, we could broadcast this video to you, right?
Yeah.
But once we add one more person, so if I would be alone, it would be much more difficult for me to monitor the class, right?
Right. You're welcome.
So he adds some value, and he's probably this increasing marginal product, right?
Right.
But once we add one more guy, so what is one additional guy could do here?
You could have this scenario, like you could have like five extra people who have no idea about like these things.
Right.
But when you add me, even though in the beginning it was diminishing,
right.
You added me, it increased.
Yeah, so that just
like that is.
Yeah, let me do it a little bit louder than Ramazan is saying. Ramazan saying, okay, but in real life, not in this course, in real life, what could happen? You could first add few people that have no idea about computer,
right?
And they have no idea how to monitor people asking questions. And as a result, the marginal product for all these people, starting from second to say fifth, will be zero. But
right.
Suddenly Ramazan came in and he brought some additional value.
I guess.
Okay, so Ramazan is going smoking. So right now our marginal product for Ramazan is going to zero. No, take a rest, guys. Take a rest, 5 minutes. So we are coming back at 2:30. So let me double check what is going on in the chat. Okay.
Oh yeah, we're going over question three. There was just in question number one, there was just one additional part to draw graphs, but I will not do it here. I believe it's more or less clear how to do it, right?
Okay, yeah.
Could you look in? Oh, okay. No, sorry.
It's still my reminder that we need to stop, but we already stopped. Yeah, we still have 6 minutes of break. I'm just writing down the one of quiz problems that we will discuss. Okay.
So
228. Okay. It just waited. Does it work? Huh?
It does work, but I messed up one of the connections apparently.
It's fine. That's good. You wait for.
it sensor isn't. And what I mean by light sensor is that it should be
flash
auto locking. I don't know about the flash, but.
Okay, let's start.
Yeah, they will be hearing us. It's 1 minute delay, so let's be probably the start, right? So okay, yeah, we're starting at 2:29 because the people behind the screen will hear us in 1 minute, and Ramazan is still monitoring the questions from people behind the screen.
And you're remoting
the... No, I'm remoting here because this is question number 3.
No, I'm saying the angle.
Oh, I will change later on. You just. Okay, you just if you see badly Ramazan, just let me know. If you see that picture is not clear or whatever, you just monitor everything, quality and all the issues. Right, so we're switching to problem number C. So in problem number 3 from homework number 3, you have, suppose a competitor firm can sell its output for $5 per unit. So let's just keep in mind that our product costs $5.
Isn't for the output for number 1, isn't that 60?
It's 60. It's written badly.
Okay, yeah, I thought that was 50, my bad.
No, it's not your bad, it's probably my bad. For writing badly. Okay. We are printing nowadays so much that our handwriting becomes sometimes terrible. Right, so we could sell each product for $5. Okay, and there is infinite demand for this product. So even if you produce 1,000, we still could sell each individual product for $5. Okay. The following table and this table gives you information about the firm's short-run production function. And basically, in the homework, you just had these two first columns. Okay. But I'm going to fill in additional columns because they will provide us with some additional information. Okay. And this will help us to answer the following question. So the following question is, determine several points on the firm's demand curve for labor. So how we need to do it? So basically we need to answer several questions. Likewise, you have a wage for the level of $75. So please tell me how much workers you want to hire. You have wage 320, please tell me how much workers you want to hire. You have wage 340, please tell me how much workers you want to hire. Okay. In homework, you had few more points. You have few more options for wages, but I will concentrate on these 3. The rest will be similar to the analysis for 75. And these two guys, 320 and 340, is somehow special. You will see in a minute why they are special, and you'll probably already remember that they are special. And I will discuss about this a little bit. Okay? So, but let's do step by step. So let's start with this table and start to fill in something, okay? We already know something about the table. We know how to fill in marginal product, right, for this table. So we know, like, first one is not determined, but what numbers do you have here? So guys in the room will be helping me and explain what we are doing, just to remind, because we had a heavy first half of the session. Yes, we did a little. We started 10 minutes late, but we still were able to complete everything I planned to complete during that first half. Okay, go ahead, Shay.
The first one is 60.
60. So how do you know that this will be 60?
The change in output.
The change in output divided by what?
The labor.
Yeah, but we, not by nothing, right? It's just the change of output when you go from 0 workers to 1 worker. Okay. Good. I'm just trying to confuse you. But you're not easy guy to confuse. Okay. So what number will be here?
7.
Copy.
So 130 subtract from the 60, 70.
70. So we are just subtracting 60 from 130. So it will be 70. 130 minus 60 will be 70. Okay, the next number? 50. So we are subtracting 130 from 180. So it will be 50. And the next number?
40.
40. Right. Oh, it's again my bad 4. Let me write down proper 4. So we have 4
0, okay? And how do we know? With 220 minus 180 will be exactly 40. The next number will be 30. And the next one?
10.
Okay? And just to have a little bit of practice, but it also will be, yeah, let me do the following. Let me write down the zeros here. Just it will be more clear, probably seen from the other side of the screen. Okay. So let me ask this question that we just answered in part C, and this will be somehow also important for this problem, probably not as much as for the previous ones, because in previous one we were directly asked when this marginal diminishing marginal product steps in. So basically, when this happens here, when do we have that marginal product starts to fall in? Fourth worker or a little bit earlier?
Third
worker. Very good. So let's keep this in mind somehow. Starting from third worker, marginal product starts to decrease. How do we know it? Before that we have 60, then after that we have 70, it's increased a little bit. So probably guys gain something from cooperation. But after that, they already mess up. They hitting each other in the same room, or they don't have enough land to produce, to grow something on the same land, okay? And so on. Okay, very good. Let's do a marginal revenue product, right? So how we calculate this guy? How do we calculate this product, this column?
We need to remember the price.
Excuse me?
The price was always $1.
$5 per unit.
$5 per unit. So 5 times the marginal product.
Marginal product, yes. And I basically will put some, you don't need these numbers. And you will see that we probably even need a little bit less to answer this question. So I don't want you on exam to spend time, but since it was provided in answer keys, so I want to follow a little bit answer keys, but not as much. So you will see that there are a bunch of redundant information that was given to you in answer keys that you don't need to actually to fill in. Okay, good. So guys are helping me and saying that what basically I need to do to calculate these two numbers, I need to pre-multiply marginal product by the price per unit of output. And price per unit of output was 5, right? So if you multiply 60 by 5, how much do we get? 300, right? Oh, sorry, I'm not writing dollar sign. So let's be consistent. So it will be 300. Okay? What will be here? 350. We can multiply 70 by the price per unit. It will be 70 times 5. It will be 350. Let's right now calculate the revenue. Revenue is somehow important, right? We want to know how much money comes in. We also know how much money comes out. We will know the profit, right? So what will be the revenue here?
Also
300. How do you know, Shay, that it will be 300?
Output times 5.
Yeah, so you could multiply output times 5. So you have output multiplied per price, per unit of output, and you have the total revenue that you get. Okay. Good.
650.
How do you know that here will be 650?
I want 30 times 5.
Yeah, so what one thing that you could do, you could 130 remultiply by 5. And it will be exactly 650. But there is also other way to calculate it. You basically sum up these two numbers. So you know that this guy, the first guy, brings you 300 of marginal revenue product that is called the marginal revenue. This is how much he brings you revenue, this guy, 300. This is how much the other guy brings you revenue. This is 350. Okay. And actually, I was wrong. Oh, I'm doing today mistakes. Actually, we will need these numbers, okay? I'm sorry about that. Let us calculate these numbers also. We don't need here numbers, but here we need for sure. Okay, what will be number here?
250.
Okay, how do we know it? We just multiply 50 times 5 will be 250. This is additional revenue that this worker brings to the company. What will be here?
200.
We do the same calculation, just in home if you feel that we are speeding up, just at home sit down and just make calculation. You need to just multiply this column by 5 and you will get all the numbers. So it will be 150 and here will be 50. Right? And I hope Shay is checking me because
yeah.
He's probably the only one who is not sleeping in this room.
No, I'm not sleeping.
Oh, also Kobe is not sleeping, so I'm sorry, Kobe, that I told this. Okay, very good. So we're just having a minute break and we see whether Ramazan has any questions regarding this table. Yes, Ramazan?
Nick says, can you repeat how to get MRP?
MRP, right, Nick. So basically to get MRP, you need to multiply MP, marginal product, times the price per unit of output. And price per unit of output is 5. So for this problem, we are multiplying marginal product by 5. So say to get this number 300, you need to multiply 60 by 5 and you will get 300. To get this number 200, we need to multiply 40 by 5 and you will get 200. So as you see, in this exercise, you need to be very careful when calculating marginal product. If you messed up here, you will mess up here, and you will mess up in the final answer. Any other questions from them?
No.
No, okay. So I believe 1 minute passed and I properly explained this one. If somebody has still problems with calculating, then we will come back. So let's right now think about this 75. Right now we are lucky. It's not so terrible. By B, I mean, always put yourself in the shoes of this guy who owns the company, okay? Or who needs to make a decision, more precisely. So we know that in this problem, the guy who needs to make a decision is the owner of the company, right? So let's put ourselves in his shoes. So he wants to hire the workers to maximize his profit, right? And right now he faces this wage, 75. Probably it's not the best wage per day, but it's definitely better than 320 and 340, right? Okay, let's go with it. So I will provide you with a little bit different analysis comparably with what was given in answer keys. In answer keys, you were given specific rule. And if you follow that rule, you will be okay. But I will provide you some reasoning behind the rule. I will not do it as formal as in answer keys, but if you follow my steps, you will be good on exam or in any kind of problem like that. Okay? Okay, so let's do the following. So think about yourself, that you are the boss of this company and you are starting to hire in these people. And you hire one after another. And you are thinking about when hiring each additional worker, you're saying, is it a good deal for me? Okay? And if it's not, then you're not hire. If it's a good deal, then you begin to hire. Okay? So let's think about this guy. So 75. So we told before, if this first guy will be hired, this is the revenue that he brings to the company, 300. So I'm asking you guys, are we hiring this first one? So we need to pay him 75 and he brings us 300. Is it a good deal for us?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course. We will earn some extra, right, out of this 300. We need to hire him. He's a good guy, we hire him. Okay, let's think about second hire. He's bringing 350 to the company, okay? But we need to pay him also 75. Will we hire him?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Let's go further, 250.
Yeah.
Will we hire third guy?
Yeah.
The same word, 200.
Yeah.
We hire the first guy, 150.
Yeah.
50. No, this guy will bring us just 50 bucks, right? And we need to pay 75, so we'll be, in total, we will lose 25 for this guy. So why the hell do we need to hire him? Okay? So we are not hiring this guy. So how many workers in total we will hire?
Five.
So I will put answer here. So this is number of workers. Okay? So we will hire 5 workers, okay? So even before solving here, do you expect these numbers to be bigger than 5 or slower than 5?
Lower than
5, because if price increase of wage, if wage increases, then we are worse off. There is no way when wage for workers increase and suddenly this owners of big company become happy. right? They will be sad because, you know, right now I need to pay more for my workers. If price of output increase, they will be much more happy, right? Okay, never mind. Any questions so far, Mazan?
How do we know if it is five?
Five is the number of workers? Who is asking this question?
Nick.
Nick, so we just did this reasoning that we are thinking about each additional worker, and each additional worker was bringing us more revenue than we needed to pay for him. And that's why we decided that it will be five. So if you see in MRP, you basically find the first number that is below the wage, 75, this will be 50. And then you stepped one step back, and you will see 150 is higher, still higher. So this, and go to the first column, and you will find the number of workers that you need to hire. For more formal way of doing it, please read the answer keys. Not today, read, but watch the answer keys online, okay? Let me go further, because we'll be doing absolutely the same, but for different number. This will be a little bit tricky, so let's be careful, okay, is it? So we have right now the wage 320, okay? Let's do the same analysis. So let's start here. We want to hire first worker. Will we hire him?
Yeah.
Yeah, so say.
Technically,
yes. No.
Technically, no, but what we're doing.
Yeah, you know, but it's just like, technically, no. We just see, okay, this guy brings us just 300 and we need to pay him 320. But let's think about the second guy. Suppose it somehow mistakenly, like doing the same logic that we did before, but we mistakenly hired him. Would we hire the second guy?
Yeah.
Yeah, because he brings 350. Okay. But we need to pay him just 320. So there is profit of 30 bucks there. So we should hire him, right?
Yeah.
But the problem is this logic. We would like to hire the second guy. But unfortunately, in order to get this marginal product, we need to hire first guy. Because we are getting this marginal product if there is first guy. Because once we hire them two, they become more productive. Okay? And this is where this law of diminishing marginal return per, marginal return product steps in, because starting from this third worker, the marginal revenue product and marginal product starts falling, right? And then we don't care. We just apply the previous rule that we just used. We just find in the first number that is below, step one, make one step back, and we find the correct answer, okay? But here we need to do a little bit more analysis, because it looks like first worker, no profitable for us to hire, but second, there is some benefit from hiring him. So basically, we are deciding for here, we are deciding between 0 or 2. I don't know whether you properly see it, but I hope you do. But if not, I'm basically saying that for 320, we need to decide whether we will hire 0 or 2 workers. We will not hire one worker, because for one worker, for sure, we will lose. We will get 300, but we will pay 320. Okay?
Yep.
I am not answering the question how we will decide whether to hire 0 or 2. We will answer this later on. After, why we are not hiring more than two? Because after third worker and starting up to all below, the revenue of additional worker that worker brings to us is below his wage. We will never hire third worker, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and so on. Okay? Let's do the same analysis for 340. This is preliminary analysis. We still didn't answer the question. We have only 50% chance to guess correctly, either 0 or 2. But this is already good. It's already good enough. At least some estimate, right? Okay, what about 340?
One, 0, 2 again.
Yeah, it's pretty much the same analysis. 340 is greater than 300. So it looks like first guy is not profitable for us. But the second guy does. So it's either 0 or 2. Okay, guys, so how do we decide between two? Will it be 0 or will it be 2? And Ramazan will say for us whether he sees properly below this. Could we write down here, Ramazan?
just here. Do you see it on screen where I'm like writing down something?
Yeah,
it's everything clear. Okay, so we will be continue writing here. You don't need much space. I will try to put everything here just to not mess up, not make you confused. You still see this table. If you will be reviewing this at home, just stop the video and you will see everything that is written, okay? And clarify for yourself whether you understand how everything is going. So once again, probably online somebody has an answer and you'll wait 1 minute for online answer. So the question is how to decide whether to hire 0 or 2. Our previous analysis just give us this hint. It should be either 0 or 2. Nothing else could be said. Could be there a way to figure out what is better, 0 or 2? Yeah, if you know the answer, go ahead.
Could we just say their wages 320 and 320, so that would maybe 640 that it will cost you. So and then if you add how much they will make you, it will be 650. So it will be 10 more than they will cost you. So you hire both of them, so they're bringing in a profit of 10.
Okay. Let me rephrase what Shay is saying. I don't know whether you hear him properly, but I believe what Shay is trying to say. He's saying, let's do the following. Let's calculate the revenue, and basically we already have this revenue, right? Revenue means how much money we are getting from selling whatever we produce. And let's compare it with cost, like how much we are paying in order to produce that. So that will be total cost against revenue. So whichever is higher, we will do the following. So if revenue is higher, then it implies that profit is positive, right? If cost is high, it means that profit is negative. And if profit is negative, it doesn't work for us to do it, to employ anybody, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so we do this. So profit for 0 workers will be just 0. So we are lucky. We just need to calculate the profit for 2 workers. So first, if we have price 320, what will be the profit if we hire 2 workers? The revenue will be 650. So we're saying 650, the revenue, minus what will be the cost of hiring 2 guys? 640. How do you know this? You know that the wage of 1 guy is 320. We're multiplying 320 by 2 because we're hiring 2 workers. It will be 640. Minus 640, sorry. I'm sorry if you don't see, but I hope you hear me clearly. So it's 650 minus 640, you'll be 10. So 10 is our profit if we want to hire 2 workers and wage is 320.
And Logan's remark confirms that result.
Okay.
You're saying if it is 2, we still get a profit.
Yes, if it's still 2, we still get a profit. Very good. So there are people following us on the other way on the screen, even so they have 1 minute delay again. So 10 is greater than 0, higher 2. So 2 is our answer here. So I leave this home exercise for you to figure out that for 340, the profit will be negative. You could check it up with reviews, right? With review to homework number 3 that is available online in homework 3 folder on Angel. There is homework 3 review link. You go, click it, and you will see that the profit will be negative and you could calculate, and that's why we hired 0, right? But once again, there is easy way to double check yourself, just that you didn't do some calculational mistakes. This number should go down if you increase the wage. Okay, cool. So we are waiting just for 1 minute approximately. If there are any questions regarding this, this problem from homework, we will move on to 2 questions from quizzes and we will be done. I don't want you to be tired too much, okay? So we'll do 2 more quizzes and we will meet tomorrow, whoever comes, okay? And we will talk about this just in after we finish with this presentation. So actually some people left us for some reason. I hope this not because we are too boring. Oh, we actually going like a little bit late. Oh no, we end at 3:30. So we still have like 30 minutes. Okay, cool. Ramadan, any questions coming from there?
No.
Okay, there's probably something with connections. People are starting to leave. Or probably there is there any football match today at 3 p.m.?
No, maybe that's the question they have. Maybe that's the confusing part. So they're like, okay.
Okay. Okay. Anyway, these people, these students who just left, they had. They will have an opportunity to review. No, actually, it's something with connection, I believe, because right now we have 5 viewers again. Okay. No questions, like Ramadan?
No.
Okay. So let me proceed very slowly to the other question. And here I will try to speak as clearly as possible because I'm not sure how clear it's seen. Is it clear, the statement of the problem, Ramadan? Or it's not clear? Oh, you have 1 minute lag, right?
Yes.
Okay, so we'll hear from Ramadan in 1 minute whether it's clear.
It should be clearly. If you can see clearly on your screen, then it should be clear.
Yeah, it's more or less clear. So I hope it's clear, okay? But let me precisely state the problem. So we have this guy, Dexter. It's the first time that I heard his name. Is it popular?
Dexter? Not popular, but famous TV show.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I'm not watching TV shows. So he was an accountant, right? And he was earning 45,000 per year, right? Okay. But then suddenly he decided to quit.
And kill people.
No. And he starts his business, which requires 80,000 to start. So it requires this amount to start. 80,000. Okay?
Yeah.
So where to get this money? So there are 2 options, and he needs to use both of them because neither of them fill in all the amount that is required. So one option is to withdraw money from his saving account, and he's doing it. So he's withdrawing 40,000 from his saving account. This number, 40,000. And additional money he's taking as a loan from a bank. This is 40,000. Okay, of course, when we're talking about loan, it's never easy. You need to pay something for that guy, for the bank. By that guy, I mean bank. If sometimes loans are free, but this is rather exceptional. So we are in US, so this is a good interest rate, just 3%. Okay, and there are 2 kind of questions we need to ask. So first question is, what is the explicit cost? And second question is, what is implicit cost? So of course, in this question, you will have 4 answers possible, and you will need to choose one. I will not provide here you any answers. You will just calculate it. We just want to make sure that we understand what's going on. OK, so what is explicit cost?
Accounting cost.
Yes, this accounting cost is just another number. It's good that we have some people today with us. So Shay is again helping us. So Kobe, could you explain what does it mean, this explicit cost or accounting cost?
Is that the cost that he earns? What is it? I'm confused with that.
Okay, it's fine. It's fine. That's why we're here. We came here to clarify something, not to become more confused, but to clarify something. So basically, it's all out of pocket cost.
Okay.
It's whatever you pay.
So would that be the money that he has from the...
No, just a second. So I will write down it clearly that people behind the screen, if you go home, they don't forget at all. Sajid told something, but he didn't write down, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So this all out of... I'm writing pocket, correct? Okay, pocket cost. Okay. And before we write down the number here, let's think about implicit cost in parallel. That we make sure that we are done with definitions and we could proceed solving problem. So what is implicit cost?
All out of pocket cost plus opportunity cost.
So implicit cost is basically just opportunity cost.
Is it just the opportunity cost?
Yes, it's not because it's something that
that's right.
Something is not that is not an explicit cost,
okay.
And total cost will be the sum of 2, or economical cost will be the sum of 2, right?
Okay, so economical cost will be the cost of 2.
Yes.
Okay.
So this will be just the opportunity cost.
Okay, very good. So let's come back. So let's come back to the explicit cost. So what we are paying out of pocket?
40,000.
Why 40,000?
From his
saving account.
Saving account.
So you know, like in this problem, let me clarify something. It's probably not written as clear as you want. But this 80,000 he needs to invest in the business, but it's not necessarily said that this money will be gone.
Okay.
It means that, for instance, you could buy some expensive device, okay, or you could, but this money, but then you could sell this money and this device, this money will come back to you in 1 year.
So,
okay. So it's not necessarily that this money are lost by him, that he needed just to throw them and that's it. So it's not necessarily goes like cost. It's a little bit implicitly mentioned in this problem. I apologize for this, but you see that it's not cost, it's not out of pocket, right? So he could return this money. So what is out of pocket here?
For explicit cost,
mm-hmm.
Would that be the money from the savings?
No, we just explained. I just was answering to Shay that this money could be returned to you in 1 year. So even so, you're paying them, like investing in your business,
mm-hmm.
but you could sell in 1 year this device. Or even if you could not sell the device, you could sell the company itself.
Okay, so that 40,000 is not fully lost.
Yes, that's what
because you can get it back later. We don't know how much of it is going to be gone.
Yeah. But we are like implicitly, we assume that everything will be saved.
Okay, but then the 40,000 that he's borrowing from the bank, he has to pay her back. We know that's going to be gone.
That's again part of it, like 40,000. It will not be gone because you invest in the company, so this will be valid something. But what about interest rate on this?
Yeah, you have to pay the interest of 1,200. So
yes, on this 40,000, this money could be returned back. But the interest, whatever happened, interest you need to pay.
Right. And that interest you're never gonna get back, I guess.
Yes. So this, you know, like a lot of companies in US run like that. They never return this money back from the funds that they borrowed, but they just returning the interest all the time. This is explicit cost they're paying per year. Or you mean like, you see what I'm saying?
I see what you're saying. Yeah.
Okay, so this is real life example. This is not just out of the wall. This is like people who were designing this was not me. I need to be honest. I was designer of the course behind this. But people were thinking about to make you some flavor of real life situation. Okay? So what we were saying is that the only cost that we found that actually explicitly needs to be paid is the cost of interest of this 40,000 that guy borrowed from the bank. Okay? So it will be 40,000. I hope I will write down 40 this time. Good. Times 3%. 3%. Or this 3%, it will be basically, if in mass translate, it will be 0.03. And if you use calculator, it should be 1,200. Shade did it without using calculator because he slept well tonight, right? So remember to sleep well before exam. That's the basic advice, okay? Okay, very good. So if you have question regarding explicit cost, please, post it in the chat, and Ramazan is still monitoring the chat and he will let us know in a minute. Okay, so let's come back to implicit cost. So implicit cost is an opportunity cost, and Kobe will have a second chance to try to help us. And do you, Kobe, remember what opportunity cost means?
Is that the additional I don't know how to explain it, but it's like, is that the
Okay, so could you try?
Is it the cost you incur from not doing the next best thing?
Yes.
So this is basically the second best option. The second best option. What would happen if this guy not start a firm, but instead of that, do something else with money? And we know from this problem what would happen with that money, right?
Okay. Would he be making 45,000 from his job?
Yeah, so the first money that he will be losing is this 45,000 from his job. He will be losing this 45,000. So we will write down here 45,000 45,000. Okay. Are there any other costs?
Oh, the interest rate, I guess. Does he have that interest? He would never have to pay it for that.
No. It's a running explicit cost. So there was a question with Shay, from Shay, whether we need to include this interest that he would not be needed to pay if he didn't start a firm, but it's already an explicit cost. We don't need to account it here.
Okay.
You know, if he doesn't start a firm, then there will be no this benefit for him.
Okay.
So don't mess up explicit cost and implicit cost. The simplest rule to remember is that if something is in one cost, it's not in another.
Okay.
Okay. So this are gone. This is not there. So which numbers do we have? Let's think about numbers that we have at all, because problem is somehow long and complicated. So 45,000. Let's put a check mark. We already did it. 80,000 is just to start business, so it's like additional information. You could just cross it. It's not very important. It's he's withdrawing 40,000 from the saving account. Did we get rid of this?
Yeah. No, we didn't, not yet.
We didn't. We got rid of this 40,000, right? Check mark. This is 3%. This is additional information. You could cross like that. We are using it, but it's not as important at the moment, right? On what we are concentrated. This is 40,000. This is the only number that we didn't use. Remember, in all your problem sets, sometimes you have some additional numbers that are not necessarily used in the solution. But if it's given for you, you need to analyze it carefully, whether it could be used or not, and then to decide.
Sorry.
Okay. So you are withdrawing 40,000 from your saving account. So what is happening? Are you losing this money?
No. Well, you're not losing it if you...
Yeah, you're not losing because it could be paid back.
Right.
Because it's in your firm, you own your firm, and if you sell your firm, you will get this 40,000. Probably a little bit less. But we are simplifying right now. We believe that you will get exactly 40,000 in 1 year. Okay? What you are losing then? Are you losing anything from withdrawing from saving account? Okay, so let me ask them the following question.
So what about the interest you get from leaving it in the bank?
Okay, so Shay just corrected himself before he said that no, we are not losing anything. But right now Shay is saying, okay, but suppose this guy didn't start a company. And instead kept that money, 40,000, in his account, right? And then he would earn interest on that money. And this interest, if he starts a company, never show up, right? So this is the opportunity cost, the second best option that he is losing also.
Uh-huh.
So here we will plus 40,000 times 3%. And let's be here very careful. Here 40,000 we have, and here 40,000 we have. So as numbers, they are the same, but meaning is completely different. This 40,000 is this shaped line, right? How do you call this line?
Squiggly.
Squiggly?
Squiggly.
Squiggly. With this squiggly line, right? This money he borrowed from the bank.
Yeah.
And this is the explicit cost or interest rate he needs to pay on this money. And this 40,000, he withdrew from his saving account, and he will not be earning interest anymore. So this is the cost he gave up in order to start his business. So this is his second option. Okay? And we are plusing here 45,000. 45,000, this is the money that he is losing from his job, because otherwise he would be earning this money from his job, but right now he needs to concentrate on his business. Okay? So, you know, this number, it will be 1,200 plus 45,000. So it should be 46,200. It's a little bit tricky exercise, but I hope it at least clarified to you what we are doing. And as you see, it's a good idea to think about real life more closely, how it goes in real life, what you are losing, what you are not. And remember, quizzes are available for you to review. So if you go back and click on quiz, you will see your quiz, like link for your quiz. You go there, you see all the questions, please read them carefully. Understand why the answer you provided is correct, is in fact correct, okay? Because similar question could show up on exam and you will be saying, oh my God, I didn't do it. I didn't clarify for myself and I don't know how to solve. And on exam, it's very, I mean, it's quite intensive exam. You need to be prepared to do everything fast. So here we go a little bit slow, just in order to clarify for everybody. We leave this 1 minute of delay. Ramazan right now is checking and saying us whether we have any questions from online viewers. No?
No.
No question. Okay. I hope that it's not because everybody left us.
Almost.
Almost. All of us, everybody left us. Okay. So everybody was bored. Okay. Let me do then question number two. So we're still broadcasting it. And even the people that left us could see us later on. Let me do it very quickly. Okay. So the question is the following. Suppose you're the owner of a bakery and you're selling bagels. Are you pronouncing it correct?
Yeah.
Okay. So you could sell one bagel for $1, and there is, you know that you employ 4 bakers, and marginal product for the last baker is 12, and the current wage rate is 8. So you're paying for all your bakers $8. The question is, could you increase profit? And there are a bunch of answers, but let us speculate whether you could increase profit or not. I don't remember exactly what choices were given.
You couldn't increase the price.
So there was a suggestion from Shay to increase the price, but you couldn't increase the price. There is no such option in the answer keys. And it's usually assumed that it's competitive market.
Okay.
So that's not the something
you cannot
change the price.
If you add one more worker, what will be his marginal product revenue?
Yes. So this, right now the suggestion is correct. So Shay is proposing to add one more worker. So what's happening when we add one more worker? So we are assuming that marginal product will probably not change much. It remains the same on level 12. So he brings to company 12 bucks, right? But the current wage is $8, so you'll pay to that worker $8, right? So there is profitable business to hire that worker. It's somehow similar to what we did before. Okay, this is the point where I want to finish up, unless in 1 minute we will see some question from online viewers. If I'm not mistaken, there is just one online viewer currently behind two of us, me and Ramazan. So I would like to thank you, Ramazan, for coming and monitoring. So probably on Monday I will be monitoring myself because there were no many questions from online users, and we checked that everything, like video goes nicely, that it's more or less clear. I hope that it was helpful for you, and I also want to thank you, Kobe and Shay, for coming today, because there was questions from them and it was good because it was more or less interactive. And also the other reason is that actually they were helping a lot, right? So we messed up with problem number one, but then we corrected it very fast because there was feedback, right? So I hope that, are you guys planning to come tomorrow?
Yeah.
Okay, so tomorrow, but most likely we will be meeting at 6:30. Is it good for you?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Most likely we will meet tomorrow at 6:30 p.m. So let me tell you just this. We will not be repeating today's material. No point in repeating it twice. You have online video. Please go on YouTube, watch it again if you find it useful. There is no benefit from watching it several times. So if you understand from the first time, no point. You know, like you calculate, you know how to do calculations. No reason to overtrain. It's better to concentrate on other material. Try to do practice problems or quizzes or whatever. You have plenty of material that needs to be, that you could practice if you require, if you feel like wise, you require more practice. So what we'll do tomorrow, similarly to today's session, we will discuss probably like 1 or 2 homework questions and some quizzes questions, like 1 or 2 quiz questions. As I see from time, so right now we have 3:13. It's more than enough for 2 hour session, a little bit less than that. And we feel more or less fresh, right? So we're not like completely screwed up, you know. Okay. If there are no more questions, so see you guys tomorrow. And I hope that we will have probably more viewers also.
This way it will be a little bit more interactive. Okay, Ramazan, any questions, sir?
No.
No, okay, so thank you, everybody. Okay, I'm